bird that's been riding herd over us ever since we pulled that express car job.
Yeah, he's been after us just long enough.
Wait a minute.
Give me that stick of dynamite.
I'll fix him. Caved in.
He's done for, Chief.
Let's get out of here. Is that all we get? Not enough to pay for the dynamite we used.
I want my part.
Oh, you shut up. Well, what are we going to do for money? With them Secret Service men and railroad dicks trailing us like that guy up there?
With him out of the way, I think we'd better hightail it for the border.
Just a minute, Chief. I've got a note here will pick us up on our way over.
Mascot Mine struck it rich. Shipping dust every Wednesday by stage. Why didn't you let me know about this before? Been losing money here for weeks. Let's go. Their winches just as they're loading that stuff on the stage.
Come over, play and get
out. Up!
They'd be holding up the stage today and get with William.
Well, we'd better get more armed guard.
I'd rather you wouldn't ship that gold today.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, the government is trying to find their hideout and trace the loot they've taken.
Here she comes now. We're just in time. She'll reach the mine in about 20 minutes. While she's loading up, we'll drift down below and get set for a warm reception. Let's go.
Stag is coming, boss.
Come on, you fellas.
They get that box, they'll earn it. Now I'm going out and see what happens.
And you here now.
Oh!
Quiet.
I couldn't help that accident.
Wait here.
That fellow trailing us again. I thought you said he was dead.
I'll stop him.
Wait a minute. No shooting. That'll clear our holdup. Get a rope. Quiet. Joe, drop a loop over him when he comes under the rock there.
You jump on him.
Shut up.
Quiet.
Here, get a hold of that rope. The water fall over the cliff.
Is he?
Impossible! You can get back on the stage. All we want is a box.
Get the box.
I said get back on the stage.
Cute, eh? How about a little kiss?
Say, mister, that ain't right.
Who asked you? You have pretty hands.
Nice suit. Don't do that.
Give it to me.
No.
Give me the pants.
The pants? No. No, not the pants. Not the pants.
Give me them bands.
No, no,
give me
no.
Them bands.
Keep your eye peeled, Slim. No telling who's watching around here.
Don't worry, Chief. Detectives are my meat.
Let's go, boys. Take your horses, Burrell. We'll figure this out. Now we're going to see something.
What's the matter?
What's the matter?
Some guy knocked me out. Must have gone to the shack.
See what that is.
Keep still.
Have some old iron for sale, Pete. Don't try it, Pete. We've got enough metal around here without you getting any lead in your system. Your last hold up, Pete, and I'm taking you with me.
Take him in the house there. Wait a minute. Get him down. What's this? U.S. Deputy Marshal.
Say, we'll have to get rid of him.
Put him in the shack. What you fellas doing? Letting this deputy get in here.
It wasn't my fault, Chief. I was getting me new suit of clothes. See? I gotta go off the stage.
What's this?
One of the gals go off when they see me in this clothes.
Listen to this. He does not know that her father made his will that way. But when the lawyer reads it to her on the 18th, she will discover that she will have to be married before 12 o'clock or lose the entire fortune. So I want you to be here when the time comes and marry her. Then you can get hold of the money as her husband and give me half of it for arranging the matter this way. And here it says the girl's name is Dorothy Horton. Why, the nasty double-crossing thieving woman. Can you beat that? Where's the bird you got this from?
I took his clothes away from him and left him in the woods.
Well, I'll be darned. The dirty crooks. Say, they want to steal this little gal's money.
I should be the fellow to marry the girl and get the money. See?
Put this on, Jim. Come back, Nick.
Get me a pair of pants.
I got no pants. Wait a minute. I'm not going to hurt you.
I won't hurt you, lady. I
mean no, Sally.
Wait.
Where's the gold?
Somebody must have put him wise.
And I've got a pretty good idea who it was.
Listen, you put this over right now, so we'll get something out of it.
Say, what are you going to do with the deputy?
Leave him here. We'll clean up on this and get out of the country.
His will in this envelope and asked me not to open it until your 18th birthday.
But I don't understand. Why should Father have me live with a neighbor if he had any property to will me?
That's perfectly all right, my dear. I talked it over with your father before he died, and I convinced him that it was for your good.
Here is what it says. If my daughter is not married by noon on her 18th birthday, my entire fortune shall be given to charity.
Well, what time is it now?
It lacks just 15 minutes of 12.
A quarter to 12? How can anybody expect me to find a husband by that time? Besides, I'd have to love him.
Now, don't you worry, my dear. Everything will be all right. My nephew will be here on the stagecoach any minute now, and he will marry you, for I have sent for him.
Your nephew, I understand everything now. You influenced Father to do this to get his money. But I will stand for it. I won't marry anybody. I'd rather see the money go to charity.
Why, I never heard of such a thing. You have to marry him. Who's going to pay for this trip? I'll see if the stage is coming now.
I can. I just sent for the sheriff.
Well, what about my ring?
When will the sheriff be here? Here he is now. You sent for your posse yet?
I'm getting my boys together right now.
Has anyone seen my nephew, Mr. Hezekiah Simmons?
What's he look like?
Oh, he's, he should be here. I expected him on this stage.
Losing that gold shipment is a serious matter. We've got to get those bandits.
Driver, you lead the way. That's all right, Dorothy. If we find out they're trying to defraud you, we'll fool them.
How?
You go through with the ceremony and immediately apply for an annulment. I'm the district judge, and the case will have to be tried before me, and I guarantee to free you.
You ride in and ask the way to this Horton girl's home. We'll wait here till it's over.
Hey, okay, Chief. Don't you want me to go in with you and be your best man? Maybe I'll get a kiss from the bride.
Go on.
Young man, would you like to get married?
Who, me?
Yes. It won't take a minute. It's perfectly simple. All you've got to do is marry the girl, and I'll pay you well.
Not on your life. My wife would skin me alive.
Oh.
My name's Hezekiah Simmons. Can you tell me where Miss Dorothy Horton lives?
Why, yes. She lives up north by the edge of town.
Thanks.
Why, you're not Hezekiah Simmons. I think I ought to know, seeing that I'm his aunt.
Yeah, and you ought to have known better than to have written this letter to him. Suppose I show it to the sheriff. Well, am I your nephew? Do I marry the girl?
Will you give me my share of the money?
Sure.
Judge Williams. He has charge of Dorothy's affairs.
Glad to know you, Judge.
Hetty has agreed to help us out. Don't you think he's just wonderful?
Yes, I suppose so.
I do.
Is it customary to wear guns at wedding ceremonies?
Oh, pardon me, Judge. Shucks, any man ought to be proud to have a gal like you for a wife. Especially when there's a fortune goes with her.
Then you admit the fortune is what is attracting you.
My, it must be almost 12 o'clock. Don't you think we ought to hurry with the ceremony?
Now, about that money my future wife is going to get. Just what is it?
Here are some of the securities. The balance will be available after the ceremony.
Lead the way and we'll catch up with them bandits. Here.
Are you the sheriff?
Yes.
They held up the stagecoach and took all my clothes and all my money.
You see anybody riding by here?
Yes, a streak of lightning. Just went by.
Give him a blanket. Get on a horse.
Should be perfectly satisfactory.
Sure, that's fine.
My, what time is it?
There's just 2 minutes to go.
Oh.
We had better proceed with the ceremony.
Come along, dear.
Well, Jim ought to be getting back by here by now.
Yes, and I wonder what he's going to do with a wife.
Miss Horton, is it your desire that this ceremony should proceed?
Why, yes. Now, don't be nervous, Dorothy.
Have you the ring, Mr. Simmons?
Well, no.
Oh, here it is, Judge.
Who are you?
Why, he's a bandit.
forget him.
Wait! I won't marry him at all now. Then you lose the money and it will be your own fault.
I'm sorry if I spoil things, but I heard that man scheming with his gang to trick you out of your fortune.
Yes, and I suppose you used this way to beat them to it. Thought you could take his place and get the money for yourself.
That's an idea, ma'am. I never thought of that. If the young lady is willing, I'd be glad to oblige her.
If you're going to marry her, young man, you may as well understand that Dorothy intends to file an annulment as soon as the ceremony is over. And as district judge, I certainly will dissolve the marriage.
That suits me fine, Judge. You know, I have other things to do besides marrying for keeps.
That's all right. Now, young lady, we may as well get this over with.
Well, you know, Judge, I've got to get married to save that money.
It's all off, Pete. That sneaking coyote we left in the shack got free and butted in just as the judge was tying the knot.
Dirty double-crossing hound. We should have plugged him.
If I would wear the girl, and the girl would marry the suit, I mean, if the suit would marry...
Shut up.
I've got it. See the badge we got from that deputy?
Yeah.
We'll use it to good advantage. Now listen. We'll go up to the house.
By the power vested in me by the state, I pronounce you man and wife.
I want to thank you for your kindness.
Oh, that's all right, miss. We all get in a jam once in a while.
I suppose he wants the money now. You can't tell me that this wasn't all a scheme.
Judge, I'm ready to sign the annulment papers.
If you'll wait just a moment, I'll draw up an agreement.
All right.
You'll be sorry for all this. Her father wanted to keep the money in the family.
Yes, but not just exactly in your family.
One favor I'd like to ask before I go.
Well, what is it?
Put up your hand. Under arrest. No, you don't. I'll drill you. Been robbing stagecoaches again, huh? These are my deputies. Search the house.
The meaning of this.
I want them papers.
Try it. You... Oh.
You can take me, but leave these folks alone.
Now you're talking.
Here they are, Chief.
Watch outside.
Thank you.
recognize his horse. I'll bet he's inside stealing my bride and my money right now.
Just in time, Sheriff. Here's one of your bandits.
It's a lie. That's Black Pete. He's got my badge.
Don't let him fool you, Sheriff. I'd prefer federal charges against him later.
Why, he's got the loot in his shirt right now. He stole from these folks.
Take him away, Sheriff. I'll follow later.
Get him out of here.
The folks are in the other room. They can tell you.
Give me that.
Say, you look like the fella I seen robbing the stagecoach this morning.
Well, I ain't.
Oh, there you are. You're to blame for all this. If you'd been here, this never would have happened. Oh!
I couldn't get here. I was with the...
Sheriff, you're making a mistake that you'll regret before the day's over.
Never mind. I'll take the responsibility. Get on the horse. Like a posse coming, boys. Let's get out of here.
Sheriff's posse.
Oh, get out of here and get some respectable clothes on.
Thank you.
now.
He stole the money and took the buckboard.
Come on, boys.
Catch!
He's got the bonds. Give these to the girl's guardian.
Come on.
I want to apologize to you for my mistake.
That's all right, Sheriff.
Your badge.
Thank you.
Let me get you some water.
Thanks. I'm all right.
Thank you.
me help you, mister. I mean my husband.
Thank you, miss. I mean my wife. Oh, I forgot. I've got to sign those annulment papers. And if I do...
I won't be your wife.